Hey, and welcome to Channel Shibitahala here on ChannelFireball.com. Today I'm playing a standard daily events with Bant Delver, you see here, which is a deck that was played in the PTQ on the 22nd and got 15th place. I was just scouring for interesting deck lists and I found it. And there's actually a few things I like a lot about it, like the use of Delver and Clapton Raptor in conjunction with Slaznia Charm and Call of the Conclave. The synergy between those cards is pretty good, I think. And that made me intrigued. A lot of the other cards I really can't agree with, but I don't have any experience with the deck, so I'm sure some of these are like moderately playable. But then we get to the sideboard, we see a lot of the same things being repeated and things that I just wouldn't really want to include in my deck, like Druid's Deliverance and Bluster Squall and Aetherize. But we're playing the deck exactly as it was, despite my objections. There's also 4 Simic Charm, which is a reasonable card, but we're already playing 4 Unsummon, and I don't really see this card doing much else besides Unsummoning. Well, I will definitely Giant Growth with this card a few times, but I would rather see like Azuri's Charm. I think that card is generally a lot better. And then, of course, you know, Faith Shield is also redundant of one of the effects of Simic Charm. So that's probably another card that doesn't need to be in here. Rootborn Defense is another redundancy of Simic Charm in some ways. More expensive, more narrow, but it also does sometimes produce a token. And there is, you know, Geist of St. Traft, which is nice to produce another Angel token. In fact, there is like a, I guess you'd call it a nut draw, for this deck to go Raptor and then turn 2. Well, turn 2 you can do anything, but then you go Geist into attack, Angel Token levels up the Raptor. Rootborn Defenses levels up the Raptor again. That gives you an Angel that stays around. And also that keeps your Geist alive through that attack. So that's a pretty good play. Not something I think is necessary to do when you have to play a card like this card. Or, you know, in that many copies at least. 22 lands is probably the fair number for this deck. I would like to see another island, I think, because you want to have a turn 1 Delver or Cloudfin Raptor. And right now there's only 8 ways to do that. That's pretty bad. Like 11 ways is like the number I want to see. Playing that many islands does hurt you when you're playing Slesnia Charm and Call the Conclave. But I think it pays off, since you can then just... You can still go Island, Raptor, or Delver. And then you can't cast one of these, but at least you cast your one drop on turn 1, so. I don't know, I'd probably want to see like at least one to two groves out for islands. And I'd like to see more counterspells main deck, more negates in the sideboard, I think. But anything else, I'm not sure yet, so let's just get started with the deck. Alright, round 1, we're on the draw. A very, very slow hand. See, if I kept this, I'd probably have to Snapcaster on turn 2. And then I guess Geisting on turn 3 is good in enough matchups that this is just a keep. And he did Mulligan to 6, which is actually really helpful for us keeping this hand. Sure. I guess I can play that on turn 2 instead of Snapcaster. Yeah, there's just so many cards that are reactive in this deck. And also at the same time pretty narrow. So what's he got going on? He doesn't want to attack because he doesn't have another land. Or he could just have Restoration Angel. If he had a Grizzly Salvage, it doesn't really indicate whether or not he has a Grizzly Salvage. He may or may not play it on his turn. Restoration Angel is the more likely thing. Which we could Spell Rupture. Or we could just play Geist. Definitely just playing Geist here, since we have Rootborn Defenses. Well, you know, since we actually just would like to get a threat into play before we do anything. If I was going to attack, I could have done it first. And then if you had Resto, I would Simic Charm. But I just don't want that. I don't want to trade with Arbor Elf either, so. Okay, he did have just Grizzly Salvage. 3 and Burial Rites. Yeah, he picked Temple Garden. Pretty likely pick there. So now we're in actually pretty good position once we untap. So if he does Thrag Tusk, okay, he might Thrag Tusk. That's the only thing that would really matter. I think. Obsidats. That's a little worse than Thrag Tusk, actually. Oh, he didn't blink it. Ooh, this could get interesting. Ah, that is a lot worse than Thrag Tusk now. Let's see. We just unsummon, attack for 9, and then we leave open, I think, 3 mana. We do have options. We could just Rootborn Defenses for the Angel. I would rather have Spell Rupture open, I think. Even though, is there really a card that I would need to counter if I have a 4-4 Angel in play? In addition to the Simic Charm and Snapcaster Mage. Who knows? It's hard to say. So I think let's play it safe. There probably isn't one, but I think I would rather still play it safe as long as I can kill him next turn. And can I do that? Well, actually, I just went to my combat, so now I don't have the option of Rootborn Fencing. That was a bit of a misclick. But I think I would still do the same thing. Because we can kill him with Simic Charm. If we draw a land, we can Simic Charm Snapcaster Unsummon. And let's see, yeah, he has to, in order to just not die to this, he has to block here. Okay, he's going for something to reanimate with rites. So he got a Thrag Tusk, which I'll just counter, and then that's the game. He also, yeah, he found a land, but that's not really relevant. He had to find a land to be able to cast the rites. Unless he drew one, but... So far, I actually like this deck. It's pretty cool. Nothing. Restoration Angel. So I can't counter it. That's bad for me. Actually, maybe I should have just played Snapcaster. If I had Snapcasted, I would have exactly lethal power in play. Then I would bounce the Restoration Angel. He'd have to block with Arbor Elf. And it's not really significant either way. The only way it's significant is if he had Angel of Serenity next turn, which I can prevent by getting rid of the Arbor Elf, I think. So what will happen then is he's going to have the Angel block the Geist. I think, Simic Charm so that I have 2 mana open. I can kill him with double Simic Charm. I think. Unless he blocks with the Arbor Elf too. Yeah, there's a lot of things I could do. I could bounce this, make him block with this, that way he can't Serenity. Or no, he wouldn't have to block with this on board, but with the other charm, he would. He's just dead to the other charm no matter what happens. I can just bounce both those guys right here. 6, 9. No, that's not true. One of these has to be used to pump. So many variables here. It all seems so obvious, I'm sure, but I have a lot of options in my hand. So let him block. Pump. Pump. Yeah, he just dies. If he blocks the one creature, he dies. Okay. So let's let him block and see if he blocks with both. Okay, he dies. I might have to take back what I said about Simic Charm. I think it actually works pretty well in this deck. But still, the Rootborn Defenses, the Faith Shield, and the Druid's Deliverance could all probably leave. Though I do like the Deliverance in the sideboard, come to think of it, because against like Mono Red or Red Green, it's a pretty hard card to beat. Yeah. Okay, so Purify the Grave, I think Syncopate. Also, one thing I like about the sideboard is that it keeps the Augur count, or the Delver flipping count, pretty high, with only four cards that don't flip Delver. Which is really, really necessary, because we're not going to be warding out creatures almost ever with this deck. So Syncopate and Purify, I think, are the only things that come in. Druid's Deliverance and Rootborn Defenses easily go. Actually, I could cut these two, probably, just because they're so bad. Almost want to bring in Smiter, but it lowers the Delver count. The original count is 24, which is exactly where I'd like to be. Going down to 22... could may or may not be worse than actually just having Rootborn Defenses. I'll just do two Rootborn Defenses. So it would be dealt to you this turn. I actually almost forgot that's what the text read.